I'm building the Taskmaster Shield from Marvel's new release, Black Widow.
I think that went right through.
This video is sponsored by Lords Mobile. We love shields.
It just chops it in half.
Is that awesome?
In fact, this channel really took off when the Captain America electromagnetic shield video went viral, way back in 2016. With the release of the Black Widow movie this summer, I think it's the perfect time to step up our shield crafting skills. This movie's antagonist, Taskmaster, possesses the power to copy and mimic fighting styles. I, on the other hand, possess the power to copy James's videos. So, in the spirit of Taskmaster, let's build his shield. Now, we need this thing to be much more powerful than any other shield we've done before. After all, Taskmaster's shield, while not being vibranium, is still strong enough to withstand blows from Iron Man as well as strikes from Captain America's shield. I want mine to be even more powerful than that. You know, maybe this doesn't have to be as complicated as it seems. Alright guys, well there you have it, Taskmaster's shield. I'm really happy with how this turned out. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you on the next one. Whoa. You didn't think we were done yet, did you? We haven't even tested the thing yet. Okay, fine, I'll do a test. Ready? Huh, I guess I've got more work to do. Lords Mobile is offering a $30,000 cash giveaway. Stick around to the end of the video for more info on that. Lords Mobile has been around for a long time and is hands down one of the best strategy games out there. It's a great mix of RPG, casual MMO, and city building. Choose an army of troops and create hero formations the way you want. Lords Mobile recently released a huge update featuring tower defense mode gameplay. And I gotta tell ya, it's awesome. It's a completely new spin on classic tower defense gameplay and includes three new challenges that are sure to satisfy any gamer. Be creative and unleash your strategic talents. And make sure you stick around to the end of the video for your chance to win the $30,000 cash giveaway. Believe it or not, we've never actually made a shield before. We've either modified or enhanced them. But for this project, we want to make the shield itself. It has to be functional, strong, and aesthetically accurate. Traditionally, shields are formed either through stamping, forging, or casting. Stamping is usually done with a big hydraulic press and a die, where the big hydraulic press puts a ton of force into the metal to get it to conform into shape. Forging is usually getting a piece of material red hot until it's nice and malleable, and then shaping it with something like a hammer. Casting is the process of pouring a molten metal into a mold, and once it cools and solidifies, it keeps its shape. Unfortunately, we don't have the equipment to do any of those three things. So what are we going to do? Okay, this doesn't look like much yet. We just have a logo etched onto a piece of 1/8-inch stainless steel, welded to another piece of 1/8-inch stainless steel. But a shield is not flat. So to give it its shape, we're gonna be using a process called hydroforming. More on that later. First, we need to give it a logo. I don't want to use paint because paint will chip and scratch during our tests. I don't want to use a sticker because the sticker will rip and peel when the shield is in action. So I'm going to be using copper because copper will be able to bind to the shield, be able to maintain its shape during hydroforming, and will maintain its appearance even through the test. And there we go, the Taskmaster logo. Time to mount it on the shield. Now that we have our logo brazed on, it's time for hydroforming. Hydroforming is the process of pumping high-pressure fluids into a material to get it to change shape, kind of like a big metal water balloon. Big shout out to Colin Furze for giving us the idea of hydroforming. Make sure you check out his channel. First up, we're hooking up the hose to the shield and the pump to allow high-pressure hydraulic fluid to flow into the shield. Next, we're hooking up the pump to the batteries to power it. Once the pump is filled with fluid, we're ready for hydroforming. Now that we have the shape we want, we have to drain the hydraulic fluid, cut it in half, and we'll move on to finishing touches. We're good. Now that it's empty, let's cut it in half. And there we go, one hydroformed shield. I only brazed the edges of the material to allow the copper to stretch during hydroforming, so now I gotta go in and braze the rest. Since copper and stainless steel won't weld together, we have to use brazing, where we use a third dissimilar material, in this case silicon bronze, to join the two. Okay, brazing's all done, time for the handle. Only on Hacksmith.store. The build portion is complete. Now we just gotta make it look pretty. I'm using a die grinder to etch my designs out so they're more defined and aesthetically accurate. Shield is complete. Time for testing. First up, let's see what it can do against mortal materials. That is awesome. Went clean through. Let's see what it can do to a piece of wood. Well, that was easy. I actually put way too much force into it and scraped my arm. The wood was pretty weak. Let's try something a little bit stronger. This thing has way more power than I anticipated, so rather than just one brick, let's try an entire wall. We've seen what it can do. Now, let's see what it can take. We know I can stop fire, but can I stop lightning?
Woo! Hell yeah! This is awesome! I feel like so much power! Hell yeah!
We know it can destroy mortal materials. Let's see how it holds up against Marvel tech. First, our original Captain America shield. No problem. The shield survived. Copper got a little scratch on it, but no issue. If you remember the beginning of this video, Mjolnir absolutely destroyed the first shield. So I'm kind of nervous to see what happens with this one. Well, here goes nothing. Not even a dent. Look at that. Literally just, it just scraped it. You can just like wipe that right off. They call it Stormbreaker, but is it also a shield breaker? Let's find out. How do I pick this up?
You're all not worthy.
Ooh, that put a good dent in it. But the shield held up. The shield held up surprisingly well in all of our tests. So I think we need a little more firepower.
How about a pump action 12 gauge? Let's start with birdshot. Yeah, a couple little marks, but nothing too serious. Let's time up the ammo. This is a Canuck operator. Yeah, there's like this little shrapnel still on the shell. The impact just flattened it completely. Not much. Let's move up.
And finally, a Bergera HMR with a Q Sidechick chassis.
Oh, it's crazy. Oh my God, look at that. Shield's holding up. Seems a lot stronger than I thought. Whew.
Lords Mobile is offering a $30,000 cash giveaway, and there's two ways to win. The top player in the tower defense ranking system will receive $3,000. Second and third place will receive $2,000, with $1,000 for the fourth and fifth. You can also spin the lucky wheel for your chance to win the remaining cash and other amazing prizes every time you upgrade your castle. Download Lords Mobile using the link in the description for your chance to win the $30,000 cash and a $350 Lords Mobile gift pack for free. Well, there you go, the Taskmaster Shield. I am really happy with how it held up through all of our testing, and I hope you enjoyed watching us destroy a bunch of stuff. If you'd like to see more behind the scenes of this project and many others, make sure to check out Hacksmith Vlogs. And for some of the best merch out there, check out Hacksmith.store. Thanks for watching and subscribing, and I'll see you on the next one.